Hi friends, welcome to my channel. Let us discuss how to find the projections of a inclined line and also we will find the traces of it. Let us take the given data. An 80 mm long line AB, the name of the line is AB, it is 80 mm long, is inclined at 30 degrees to the HB and 45 degrees to the VP. The end A, capital A, in AB line, the end A is 20 mm above HB and 10 mm in front of VP. Okay, A position has given. Draw the projections of the line and also find its traces. For doing this problem, first write the given data. So AB line length is how much? It is 80 mm. Just mark here, it is given 80 mm or 8 cm. And then A position has given, A is 20 mm above HP and 10 mm in front of VP. Okay. And what are the angles given? The line AB is making 30 degrees to the HP and 45 degrees to the VP. Okay, this is the given data we have written. After writing the given data, whenever two angles are coming, okay, same line, AB line is making two angles. One angle is with the horizontal plane, one angle with vertical plane. Okay, here we have to take two assumptions, first assumption and second assumption. We have to take instead of two, only one angle initially, angle with HP. Okay, I am taking in first assumption, angle with HP is 30 degrees. Okay, the other angle I am considering 0 degrees to the VP. Okay, in next assumption, I am taking angle with VP here, 45 degrees to VP and 0 degrees to HP. Like that, I am making two assumptions. Okay, here, for doing the projections, keeping this first quadrant like this for our convenient. So, this is the line, this is the A point, this is the B point. This length of the line is 8 cm. Okay, first we need to mark A position. A is 20 mm above HP. As I told, this is the horizontal plane, this is the vertical plane. Okay, this A point is 20 mm above the horizontal plane. This gap is 20 mm. Okay, and then 10 mm in front of VP. Okay, so this gap, the from vertical plane to this gap is 10 mm. Okay, so first we need to mark the A position. Forget about how the line will be. Okay, just assume only A point is there. We need to mark front view of A and top view of A. Okay, first mark the front view of A point. Okay, this is, if we see from this side, it is a front view, we can see on the vertical plane. Whatever view is coming on vertical plane, it is a front view. Whatever view is coming from the top, it is coming on the horizontal plane. Okay, first mark A point. So A point is 20 mm above HP. If we see from front, we can see this 20 mm gap and we can mark A point on the vertical plane. For front views, we are giving A dash, okay, small A dash, about 20 mm. We can see the A dash point here. So we have to tilt this horizontal plane in downward direction for getting the 2D view. Okay, so this is 20 mm gap. We need to mark A dash. Okay, so A dash and A coming on the same projector line. After marking front view A dash, okay, mark the top view. Top view is, it is 10 mm in front of VP. We can see the top view here. Okay, so take, this is the top view. So from top we can see this 10 mm gap. From the front, we can see this 20 mm. Always remember, whenever this is coming above HP means here above XY line, just remember like that. 10 mm in front of VP means below XY line. Okay. Always remember A dash and A should come on the same line. It is called projector line. Okay. After marking A dash A point, okay, take the first assumption. Okay. So I will take here first assumption. In first assumption, line is making 30 degrees to the horizontal plane. And then 0 degrees to VP. 0 degrees means parallel to VP. So it is making 30 degrees with HP. And it is parallel to the VP. Okay. Because it is making 0 degrees with VP means parallel to VP. And it is making 30 degrees to the horizontal plane. So front view is coming here. And top view is coming. We can see the horizontal line here. Okay. Any inclined line, if you see from top, it is getting like horizontal line. Okay. Now, in the front view, we will get the true length of the line. True length means total length of the line. First, do the total length of the line. Okay. And in the top view, we don't know the length of this horizontal line here. First, do the true length. It is front view. How much length? The given line is 8 cm. Okay. Here, do the 30 degrees line. Okay. This is 8 cm. By using compass, mark 8 cm. Give the end point B dash. Front views, we are giving small a dash, small b dash like that. In the top view, as I told, it is getting like horizontal line, okay, here. So just do the line. Always remember A dash A should come on the same line and B dash B should come on the same vertical line. These are called projectile lines. So this is the first assumption. Here, and this line is making 30 degrees to the horizontal plane and parallel to VP. Okay, this is the first assumption. Take the second assumption here. In it, just I am doing separately. Okay, after that we will combine both. So first mark A dash as it is. Same diagram, same A position. Here I am doing. Now in it, what we are assuming? Line is making 45 degrees to VP and parallel to HP. 0 degrees means parallel to HP. Now line is, our line is making like this. 45 degrees to the vertical plane and parallel to the horizontal plane like this. Okay. In the top view, we can see the inclined line. In the front view, we can see the horizontal line. Okay. In the top view, we can see the true length of the line, 8 cm. How much angle it is? 45 degrees. Okay. So I am doing separate diagram. That's why we can see the inclined line here. Just take 8 cm line here. The angle is 45 degrees. Okay. Mark 8 here. We will get, give new points instead of B dash, give B1 here. Okay. And then in the front view, we can see the horizontal line, inclined line looking like horizontal. As I told, A dash A should come on the same line and B1, this line is coming like this. Okay. Here I am giving B1, here I am giving B1 dash. Okay. So these two assumptions we are making. Always remember, angle here, this angle is with HP, horizontal plane. This angle is with vertical plane. Okay, the two assumptions here. Let us combine these two diagrams for getting the projections. First, do the XY line of any length. We can call this line as reference line also. Here, I did the line and mark the A position. A dash is 20 mm above HP, 10 mm in front of VP. Okay, in both assumptions, A position is same. Here, mark A dash and A 20 mm. Already I kept here, this is A dash and 10 mm in front of AP, this is A. Just do one projector line and mark A dash A. After that, take 30 degrees line of 8 cm. Take 30 degrees here. So in this direction, take 8 cm. Now mark B dash here. Now drop the line here up to A. Take A dash A is a reference line. At B dash, do the line of some length. And take this is a reference line here. At A, do the horizontal line. Now do the intersection point is here B dash we have marked, here B. Now we did this first assumption diagram. Do the second assumption diagram. Here at A, take 45 degrees line of 8 cm. So in this direction, 8 cm. This name is B1. Do the line, vertical line, projectile line up to A dash horizontal line. First we will do here horizontal line up to some length. After that, take this is a reference line and produce a line at B1 up to this horizontal line. We are getting this is B1, in the front view it is B1 dash. So this angle is initially 30 degrees and this angle is 45. Keep arrows for both angles. Okay, so here we have combined these two assumptions. Here, as I told, this is a AB line. It is making 30 degrees with the horizontal and again the same line is tilting 45 degrees with VP. Okay, this angle. Now, wherever first initially this angle, again it is tilting like this. This B point is moving on the same plane. Okay, whatever angle is given, it is moving on the same plane. This plane is looking like line, locus of B point. Okay, both in the front view as well as in the top view. So at B dash, and B1 do the horizontal lines. Take this is a reference line. Just do one locus of B here in the front view. Similarly at B1 also do the locus line of B point in the top. So if you are combining these two, that is it is making 30 with horizontal plane, again it is making 45 with the VP. So this is a final position of the line. If you see from front, if you see from top, it is looking like inclined line in the front view as well as in the top view. Forgetting this line, what I am doing means whatever front view is there, I am tilting in upper direction up to this line, because B is moving on the same plane, on the same line. Take this as a radius, tilt this in upper direction. Okay. Wherever it is touching, take that point is, so take this point is, instead of B and B1, we can give some other name also. B2 dash I am giving. Join this C dash, B2 dash, it is a final front view. And then we can measure this angle also, how much the final front view is making with the horizontal plane. This angle is 48 degrees. Okay. Now in the question, sometimes they may ask how much this final front view is making angle. This angle is, just do an arc here. This is making 48 degrees. This is the final front view. If you want, you can measure this length by using the scale. You can give the length also in case if they are asking in the exam. Some 5.6 centimeters, 56 mm. Okay. Similarly, we need to find the top view also, final top view. Whatever this length, till this length up to this line by using the compass. Take this as the radius. And just do an arc here. So take this intersection point is B2. Join A and B2, it is the final top view. Okay, we can measure this length. If they asked in the question, it is 6.8 centimeters, 68 mm. Okay, this length is. We can measure the angle also, how much this final top view is making angle. This angle is 55 degrees. Okay. So you can mark this angle also. So this is the final front view, this is the final top view. If you want to check whether this procedure is correct or not, here as I told, A dash A should come on the same projectile line. Similarly, final B2 dash and B2 should come on the same vertical line. We can measure by using the roller scale whether the two points should come on the same line or not. Just take this is a reference line and tilt the scale. If you check, both B2 dash and B2 should come on the same line. Okay, it is one of the process of checking the answer is correct or not. So this line should make 90 degrees with the XY line. So you check at this line, this is showing 90 degrees. Okay, so this is making 90 degrees. Whatever we did the answer, it will give the correct values. Okay. These are the final projections, and here we need to find the traces of these projections. Okay, forgetting it, whatever final front view is coming, extend it up to the XY line. Okay, just take this final front view, just do one line like this. Okay, wherever it is touching, that is a horizontal trace in the front view. Okay, similarly A dash B dash like that, we are marking H dash here. Front view extended part is touching at one point, it is a horizontal trace in the front view. That's why horizontal trace means small h dash, always remember. Now similarly extend this final top view like this up to the XY line like this. So wherever it is touching, it is a vertical trace, small v. So after getting V here, just extend this final top view in this direction. So same line, extend up to like this, up to some height. So we got H dash here. Forgetting H, do the vertical line, because H and H dash should be coming on the same line. A dash A should come on the same line like that. Take this is the reference line. at H dash, do the vertical line. So this vertical line is touching this line at H, small h. Okay, so horizontal trace, top view, horizontal trace, front view. Okay, for getting the V dash, okay, at V, take the same reference line. At V also do the line, okay, within this line, like this. So this is the V dash. So always mark the final front view touching at H dash, final top view touching at V. Okay, so extend these lines at H dash, do the vertical line. Remember one thing, H dash, H and V dash, we should come on the same line. Okay, and mark the given dimension. Here A point is 20 mm above HP and 10 mm in front of VP, and mark the angles also. This line is making 30 degrees with the HP and 45 degrees to the VP, and the line length is 80 mm. In the front view as well as in the top view. If they are asking what is the final front view is making angle, mark this angle and measure this length and do the parallel line here, dimensional line parallel to this line. Measure this value and mark at the middle of the dimensional line. Similarly, you measure this final top view length by using scale and mark this length on the dimensional line. There should be at least 1 cm gap between the final front view and dimensional line. So this is the process of doing the projections as well as finding its traces. If you like this lecture, please press the like button and subscribe my channel and share with your friends. Thank you for watching.